Now that we have installed and configured Python on our machine, it's time to learn how to write and execute a program in Python programming language. What's up internet, I am Manish from RebellionWriter.com and I am back once again with Python programming tutorial. In this tutorial, we will learn how to write and execute a Python program along with how to clear the Python prompt screen as well as how to exit from the Python prompt. So without wasting much of your time, let's get started. But before that, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, as many such interesting videos are coming your way. Now let's start. The easiest way of writing and executing a Python code in Windows is through command prompt. Let's check out how to do that. Here I am on my command prompt. You can always check the corresponding blog in order to learn how to launch command prompt in case you don't know. Link is in the description. Anyways, now that we are on the prompt, next we have to start the Python interpreter. To start the Python interpreter, we are provided with two commands. The first command is Python. Yes, just write Python in your command prompt and press enter. That will start your Python interpreter. The second command is py. Simply write py and then press enter. That will do the same. Choice is yours. Go with whichever way you prefer. In case your command prompt denies to recognize the Python as an internal command, then make sure you have added the Python directory path to the environment variable. I have demonstrated how to do that in the previous video. You can check that out. Now let's move ahead and write our first Python program. And no, it will not be the generic hello world. That's what normal people do. We are rebellion writers and we code in our own style. Thus, our first program will going to be what's up internet, our favorite string. Let's write it. This single line is an executable statement. In this statement, we are calling the print function of the Python language and asking it to print the supplied argument on the output screen of the user. That supplied argument in our case is our favorite string, what's up internet. Python is not a compiler based language, rather it is an interpreter based programming language. Compiler converts the entire program into the machine language in one go, whereas interpreter converts the program by taking a single line at a time. Which means as soon as you hit the enter, the Python engine will straight away show you the result. So let's do it. Here is our result. Before moving ahead, let me clear a few things for you. Python is a case sensitive language, which means all the function calls which you will be seeing on your screen are different and work differently. The first print function call, where the name of print function is written in all small letters, is the only legitimate function call which will be recognized and executed by the Python interpreter without any error, while the rest will raise error. Let's quickly check. We have already seen the working of first function call. Now let's see what happens if we try to write the print function name in all caps. We got an error. Name print is not defined. Now let's check the third function call by trying to write the print function name with capital P. Let's execute. Once again, the same error. Hope these demonstrations have clarified that Python is a case sensitive programming language. Similar to case sensitivity, Python is also an indentation sensitive language, which means with Python programming language, you need to be very careful with your spacebar or tab key. A single white space or a mistakenly pressed tab key can cause an error. Let's do a demonstration. Suppose unknowingly you pressed the space key before writing the code, which in our case will be the print function call. Let's see what will be the output of it if that happens. But first, I think we should make some space in our Python prompt so that we can see our code clearly. Let's scroll a little bit more, a little more. Oh, it looks great. Now let's press the space bar first. Great. Now let's start writing our code. Let's execute. As you can see, we got an indentation error saying unexpected indent. That means you need to be very careful with your spaces in Python programming language. I think we have made a lot of mess on our Python prompt, and it is the best time to learn how to clear the screen of our terminal in Python programming language. Let's do it. We already know that in Windows, to clear the command prompt screen, we use cls command, right? That is exactly what we have to do here. But there is a catch. We cannot use the host environment command in Python directly. You want to check? Let's do that. See what happens when we call cls command in Python. We got an error. Name cls is not defined. So the question arises here, if this is not the correct way, then what is? Let me try to answer that. Firstly, except from using the host environment command, which is cls in Windows and clear in Linux, we don't have any other way to clear the terminal's screen in Python. The only way to use the host command in Python is to use the function system of OS interface. Let me teach you how to do that. In order to use the function system, we first need to import the OS module. Simply write the import command. This command will import the OS module. Now we have to call the function system, which is defined and declared into this interface. Using system function of OS module, we can run any underlying operating system command. That operating system can be Windows, Mac, or Linux. For example, in Windows, using this function, you can run cls command for clearing the command prompt screen, or mkdir for creating a directory, or any other DOS command you want. But for now, let's use this function to clear the screen. Simply write the name of the interface, which is OS, followed by dot operator, and then the name of the function, which is system, all in small letters. As an argument of this function, you need to supply the command which you want to run. And make sure to enclose this command into a pair of single or double quote. We will discuss more about this single and double quote concept in a separate video. Anyways, here we have specified cls as we want to clear the screen. Now let's hit the enter button and see the clear screen. Here you go, a neat and clean screen for you guys. Before winding up this tutorial, let's also learn how to exit from the Python shell. There are two ways to exit from Python shell. The first way is to use the exit function. Simply write the name of the function along with the parentheses and hit enter. This will take you out from the Python shell. Like this. Out from the Python. Another way to exit from Python shell is to use the keyboard shortcut Ctrl plus Z. Let's try that too. We are once again in our Python shell. To exit from it, simply press Ctrl plus Z and then enter. Once again, out from Python. That was a quick tutorial on Python language. We learned various small yet useful things here. These minute concepts can save you from various errors. Stay tuned, as in the next tutorial we will learn how to create a Python script using IDLE editor. Please give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends on your social media. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionWriter.com.